We have sound again. It was a bad start to the stream. I've changed my setup, as you can see. I've got a kind of an actual face cam, and I've got I've got some other little bits. I've been changing everything around. So yeah, that's forget to check my sound. Rookie mistake. So hello to everyone. Good evening. This is Friday evening for me, so I imagine there's a few different time zones across the world. So good evening, whatever you're up to. And today we are going to be doing some kit bashing, as we usually do on these streams. So let's go straight into it. So I've actually had some nice little. I've had this like nice little bit of an equipment now. Look at this. Got myself some upgrades, so I can kind of switch between different modes like really easily. So this is basically the guy that we're going to be working on today. This is just like a little bit of a mock-up that I did. And the intention of this was just to kind of get an idea that I had in my head, and I wanted it to get it down onto a model. I've had it for quite a while, mainly since the new, the Corridor Redemptionist got released. I was kind of wanting to do something a little bit along this lines with Chaos. So yeah, so this is just a little bit kind of a Photoshop mock-up that I made. It kind of has this little bit of a kind of flaming motif going on. I didn't want to lean too heavily into that Legion of the Damned aspect, because I want to keep them fairly simple. But I'm thinking along the lines of something like the Charred Knight or the Burning Knight, something like that, something about fire. So yeah, let's get back to the camera so you can see me again. Look at this. It's all very new to me. So these are probably going to form the basis of the conversion. There's a few quite nice little braziers and other little bits of like these metal iron grates and things. I've got a few of them assembled just from when I was trying them out. So these kind of things are going to be really useful for the kind of things that we want here. So yeah. So as always, during these streams, it's going to be quite a nice little chilled out stream. If you have any questions and you want them to be answered, then leave them in the comments and hopefully I'll get back to them. And I'll keep remembering there's a camera there and actually referring to it rather than just looking at the screen. So let's get started. Right. So we need, first of all, some nice, fresh Chaos Space Marines that are going to form the basis of the conversion. I didn't even open these yet. This is how nice we've got. So let's open these. So we have, who do we have in? So we have Kabuski. I think, if I'm not mistaken, unless you've just stolen the name from the Kabuski on Instagram, but Kabuski is on my Discord, and he also has, I assume it's a he, I don't know, could be a she, we don't know these days. Has a really nice kind of Instagram where they make lots of like mock-ups, which is kind of what inspired me to do this little image here. But this is kind of, I mean, this is very basic compared to like Kabuski standards. But if you haven't done so already, then have a look on Instagram. I believe it's at Kabuski, but I'm sure that Kabuski can put it in the chat if they want to. Back to the table. So yeah, we're going to be basing it around one of these models. I don't know if I'll base it on the model that I was just kind of showing there. I might just go for one of the other. I'm definitely going to go for like an open pose, just so I can really get to the chest and get some access to some of the different items. So we'll see. Let's see. Don't want the champions, but too much. Quite a nice action pose. Quite like the look of this one. This kind of foot stepping forward. Let's go for that one. Right. You gotta watch a guy try to find numbers on a sprue now. Right, so we need 94 on the legs. What is it? 94 and 95. Mr. Arbiter, thank you very much. Always good to catch your stream. I'm really looking forward to seeing this conversion. Any ideas on what you're gonna do with those other five creatures? I do not know yet. I've got them sat in a box just waiting. I think because Games Workshop haven't announced officially when they're going to be doing like a standalone box set for them, it's been something that I've kind of been putting off a little bit, just because I didn't want to use them for something and then another kit come out and I have a really good idea for them and kind of be stuck. Unless I just went and bought another. I'm not going to do that. But yeah, I think once we know that they can be accessed separately, I'll probably go and do something a little bit kind of different with them. I've just been a bit, yeah, just a bit unsure about what to do with them because I don't want to wreck them and break them up, so we'll see. Hopefully sometime soon. Right, we also need 96. Which I believe is in a sprue here. Might have had the numbers the right way around. 96, there we go. It's quite a nice featureless torso there, so we can add some bits to it. Cool. Let's make a start on that then. So I've begun. I'm going to have to obviously scrape everything off here. This is kind of unfortunate. But I have prepped a few of these in the past, but I thought this time, let's just do the whole thing. You can see the whole person. I do apologize if you don't like the sound. This is something that does go through some people. Remove these mold lines. I don't worry too much about this. This is more of kind of a kitbash, like a prototype kind of thing. I'm not doing it super seriously, so if it gets some mold lines, that's fine. We're all good. And as is always the case at the start of these live streams, I do have to keep remembering to look at the chat because I always forget and I'm just kind of waffling on to myself thinking this is just filming a normal video. So let's see what we've got. Just found Kabuski yesterday. Already have tons of ideas on the back burner. Thanks to that, Milo. Yeah, definitely. There's quite a few. It was like a bunch of Eldar stuff, which is Eldar combined with Lumineth Realm Orbs. And I've like really, really been meaning to do one of those, but just haven't got the time at the moment. I've got some other ideas in the pipeline, but when I get a chance, I will definitely be doing one of those. Garfield. I'm guessing that's like Garfield. Yeah, I can see the icon on the avatar then. Do you think you'll ever try a hand at converting some fancy orcs from 40k orcs? So I've seen someone who did a really nice kind of mock-up. They shared it in my Discord and they basically did a mock-up of one of the new Beast Snagger orcs and they kind of made them like fantasy, which is pretty cool actually. So that might be an option for some time in the future. They kind of have this like more low-tech view to them, so that might work quite nicely. So let's hope, yep, still on the camera here. Have you thought of any lore for these dudes? No, not yet. I just had an idea that I really liked, like an aesthetic, and I thought that it'd be cool to just kind of build it and then work my way backwards. But I suppose as we're doing this, if you have any ideas for kind of lore that you want to include or you think might work well with the aesthetic I'm going for, then please do feel free to leave those suggestions below. This is a nice group effort. I'm just going to angle this camera because it's kind of just, there we go. Is that any better? Yeah, it's a bit better. Cool. You can actually see my face now. Apart from this, so basically I have my camera on this kind of swivel arm, and it's meant to be like a microphone arm. It's a, like for a Rode mic. And the trouble is I haven't really got anywhere to put the camera where I can see it with easily within my eye line. So I've unfortunately got this mass of metal in front of my face, but that's fine. Usually only see my hands, so it's all good. What's this homebrew trade strategy? Is this Chaos Marine from a specific existing chapter? This is just something that I really like the idea of and thought I'd build it and then I'll work out everything afterwards. There's nothing really too, nothing too planned out this time. Some of my homebrews, I have a lot more information, a lot more kind of background for them, but this one's a lot more just kind of laid back and chill. Okay, so we have the legs and the torso. Now, before I build anything of this, I'm actually going to start looking at some components I can use because sometimes it's easier to cut and modify things before you actually go ahead and glue anything together. So, like I said, Cordor Redemptionist kit. This has some really nice components in here that we're going to be using. So let's grab those. Okay. So, I've got a few spare components from when I built the first three guys. I think these kind of collars are going to work really nicely. I think they're probably going to be the ones that I go for. And then it also means that these are spare, so I'm not even using up any bits. So I'll grab both of these and we can see how this turns out. So I think Kabuski has, yeah, Kabuski shared their Instagram in the chat, so please do check them out. Some really nice stuff on there. And then if there's anything like particularly that you think I should have a go at, then I'm sure you can just tag me in it or something. I'm sure I'll see it anyway, but if you'd let me know. Right, let's go for that. What's that? Is that kind of like a... That might work as well. We'll come back to that. There are some really nice components on here for like anything flame related and flame themed. So if you ever want anything like that, it's really good for that kind of thing. Probably some Sisters of Battle kits as well would work quite nicely. So this is what I'm thinking. We kind of go for this collar here around the back. And then maybe something around the front. I'm not sure if this would be a bit too much, but it kind of has that cool kind of slightly dark look to it. Yeah, let's go for that. Let's try and remove this first, see what we get, and then we can maybe just kind of attach that to the front there. That might work quite well. Okay. If you go the Knight's theme, could be Traitor's Warband of the Grey Knights, could run with some of the Ash designs in addition to the fire. Nice. War Palapinos. Yeah, Spicy Boys. I think someone else mentioned Spicy Boys actually seeing it. It's all Alpha Legion stuff that's stolen and graded. How did you get on in the AOS tournament? So I played 5 games over the 2 days and I lost 4 and won 1, which, to be honest, is actually more than I expected. Considering up to that point, I'd only played 2 games of Age of Sigmar before jumping in on a tournament, which wasn't wise, but yeah, it was good fun. The only thing is, I ended up playing against Iron Jaws for the first 2 rounds. Then I played against Slaanesh, Hedain Knights, and I won that game. And then I went on to play against 2 Sylvaneth players back-to-back, so basically had mirror matches for the last 2. So that was the only thing. I would have liked to have maybe played a few different armies, but it is what it is. Iron Jaws actually destroyed me. Terrible. Hopefully we get a nice new book soon, and a L'Oreal will actually be a bit better. I actually have a L'Oreal in my cabinet here. Let's grab her out. Because this is a very rickety cabinet. So I've not actually shown her on my channel. She's been done. I've got everything filmed. All the stuff is done. But I just need to actually write the script and edit it all. It's all been filmed. So let's just go for... Let's go for table. There we go. So she's very, very big and chunky. She's on a giant Glotkin. So if you've been following along with my Sylvaneth series, then this is basically what I've done on there. So yeah. Really nice model. Unfortunately, not very good on the tabletop, so swings and roundabouts. Okay. Let's get the table on the face back. Okay, would you do a custom demon prince? I actually have something interesting, so keep sort of demon related, so keep an eye out for that one. You want to listen to that one. Mr. Arbiter, thank you very much, £10. Lore idea, each warband member was formerly from one of the more zealous marine chapters, but got betrayed / left for dead, and have now dedicated their passion to the dark gods. That actually works really nicely. Quite like the idea of it being something like one of the more, I suppose in a way, a little bit like how the Word Bearers, they were like uber fanatical, dedicated to the Emperor, and then they kind of just, that fanaticism just changed into something else. So rather than it being, yeah, it works really nice actually. Also fits in theme. The fireworks, they kind of like to go on a purge and everything. So yeah, that's quite nice. So, what do we have here? So following on from the tournament question, I actually used my 3D printed army at a game last week, and so that used Archaon, Nine Varangard, a Khorne Demon Prince, and a Sorcerer as well, and they were very good. They were so much easier to play than Sylvaneth. I mean, I don't know how many people of my audience actually play Age of Sigmar. I've only really gotten into the gaming side very recently, so I'm not sure if the kind of people that, I mean, maybe you are. Maybe you guys are massively into the Age of Sigmar tournament scene. But yeah, it was just kind of night and day, really. With my Sylvaneth, I felt that everything was just, it was very hit and miss. I couldn't rely on anything to do what I wanted it to, so I had to always be very cautious and kind of held back. And I was worried about exploiting weaknesses in the opponent's line, because I knew that if I didn't get that roll right, that single roll for charging or to hit or anything like that, then I knew that I was going to be wiped out the next turn, which has actually happened a few times. So even when I did try to play a bit more aggressively, it kind of backfired. And yeah, there's a guy there though, a lot of people know him by Mathmallow, and he's a Sylvaneth player and he's very good at it. I think he won 4 games out of 5, and I think he had the Drew one, or he lost one, I can't remember now. But yeah, he did very good at this tournament. He had a very similar list to me, but I think there's a few things that mine was lacking. Obviously, I was lacking experience, but he's just a very good Sylvaneth player. He knows exactly how to use them against each opponent he goes against. So yeah, it's not all the army. It is partly me as well, is what I'm trying to say. Three rats in a trench coat over on Twitch. Any plans to make rat ogres in the future? The Games Workshop sculpts are terrible. Yeah, I do agree with that one. They're very outdated and kind of quite bland now. It would be nice to do something. I think the Storm Fiends, I think. Yeah, Storm Fiends. They are quite nice sculpts, and by comparison, the Rat Ogres aren't. Which is a shame, because I don't think the Rat Ogres are that old. I think I remember them being released in plastic. And there's other kits from around the same time that aren't that bad, so maybe there's some options for using some of the orc units, like brutes, and bulking them out, maybe. We'll see. Maybe in the future. I do need to do some acolytes, some scryer acolytes, just because they're about £10 a model, but they're battle line, so I don't know how that makes sense. But yeah, lots of ideas to convert things out there. Just finding the time to do it all. But these live streams are good because it means I can just do a kind of a quick idea that I want to do, and I have to do like a full video, which takes about a week to do. I can just jump on here with some ideas, see if they work, and if they do, I can always do a full video. And if they don't, then we still have fun doing it, so that's all good. Chris Lurker, I probably use the three-pronged bit for the front instead of the back. Yeah, this is kind of, it's a little bit more open, isn't it? It's not as locked in, so I think this probably would work a little bit better. Let's bring that round. So yeah, you can see it's already going to work quite nicely there. Just need to do a little bit more trimming, and that's going to sit quite nice at the front. The next thing I'm actually thinking is whether to go for a helmeted head. I know the thumbnail, the little, let's bring up the image again. This guy kind of has the meshing going around the sides. It's a very rudimentary drawing, and I'm sure Kabuski could probably knock something up a lot better than this in about 5 minutes. But I think I'm tempted to go for maybe more of a head, as opposed to, and I kind of like the idea of, rather than the flames coming off the head, as it being like the head is burning up, so it's kind of like white hot, and it's got like the inside of the mouth is white hot, and then the skin's like is glowing red and orange. So that's kind of what I was thinking. I'm not too sure yet. So let me know what you think. We can go through. Back to the face cam. A tiger sympathizer, this train Wi-Fi is the Nurgle crotch. Yeah. I do apologize. This will be on, I will be putting it on the channel afterwards. So if you don't get a chance to watch it on the Wi-Fi, then you should be able to watch it later. You could give this model a sword, which is a flaming blade, if you have anything like that. I think I might do. I had some kind of wizards from the old Empire Wizards, and that nice flaming sword. So maybe use that. Red Lotus 101, do you have any of the Warcry Fire guys? You know what, I don't actually have some, and actually that would have been a genius idea to have some before the stream, but no. That's another good option. I think Court of Redemptionists and those guys are really good for kind of flaming options, so yeah. They would have been good too. They have some nice weapons, so. If I was doing this again, if I was doing this as like a full video, then maybe that would be a good option to do. Thank you for your suggestion. Since these guys were left to die there, maybe they could carry around the bones of forgotten space marines. You know what that means? Dead animal bits. That's what that means. Of course I'm going to go for that idea. If I can stick some bones and stuff on these guys, then they're just definitely going to get in this. The Storm Fiends are a great sculpt. Used one as a base for my Magma Hounds Demon Prince, actually. That's a nice idea. Because they have that kind of, like the rat feet that look very similar to the Demon Prince feet. So yeah, I can see how that would work nicely. The branded ones, branded by Chaos. Yeah, that's another good option. They're kind of like the branded, yeah. It's nice, it's kind of a whole thing of the, of that kind of really just dark and mysterious kind of name, yeah. So we've got Liam Middleton saying definitely helmeted. What Necromunda box is Pete using? Pete is using the Court of Redemptionists. Someone may have already answered that by the time I've read that comment, but I do apologize. Battle Mage's kit has a flame sword. It does. I'm not sure if I have any left. I might have one left. I used one on a Salamander conversion a few years ago, so I'm not sure if I had another one. Are there any plans for Primus Chapter Master 2 Shant? Yes. So I did actually kind of get everything I needed to do this, but then when I actually sat down to do the conversion, I just wasn't happy with the idea, and so I ended up just kind of putting it on hold. So it's not going to happen, but there's no immediate plans to do it. So yeah, I got really excited. Like, yeah, I'm finally going to do it. I've got some ideas for this. And just when I actually came to do it, I was just like, no, it's not going to work. Okay. So I think that's probably trimmed enough for now. I'll start working on the back. I'm just going to flatten this out completely. I think that's going to be too... that flat as well. Just conscious I'm actually keeping my hands in the shot here. I have a tendency of doing that. How much dead animal bits is this conversion? I don't know yet. It's hard. I'll give a rating at the end. If someone reminds me before the stream ends, I'll give it a rating. I'd say it's at least a 2 by now. No sculpting yet though, so it's not quite at a 3. Only used 2 kits. 2 so far. I need a dead animal bits rating button, don't I? Hotheads. Chaos Unrepentant. A good name would be the Ardent Militias or the Ardent Equities. High Gothic for Blaze and Flaming Knights. Also, what third-party stores do you recommend? Looking to get some Roman-esque Space Marines. So... if you want some Romanesque Space Marines, Liber Demonica, very good stuff. I actually did an Ultramarines conversion not too long ago. I think it actually might have been a while ago now, I think, come to think about it. And I used some of the Roman shoulder pads, and they had like really nice Roman heads, and I don't know if they have gladius swords, but yeah, they have some really nice stuff. check them out. Liber de Monica are good. Conversionworld.de are good. Anvil Industry have some nice stuff, but I think the most of their stuff, the better stuff is around like Imperial Guard regiments, things like that, not necessarily Space Marines, but they do have some kind of Space Marine stuff. Puppets War, good option too. Their stuff tends to be a little bit more cartoony than Liber de Monica and Conversion World, so yeah, plenty of options there. Right, let's have a quick drink. Don't question now, if orcs see red and think it goes faster, would a lot of orcs seeing the heads of these guys make them think faster? Quite possibly. I guess it depends whether or not orc... I guess, would they think they're faster, or would the orcs think they're... Yeah, I don't know about that one. That's one for someone, one of the lore guys on here. You should go and ask them. I just kickbash stuff. Spirits of Vengeance, that's a good name for these Ghost Riders. They basically are Ghost Riders, aren't they? I don't want to lean too much into... there's the only thing I kind of didn't want to go into too much of the Legion of the Damned, because they have this very much like flaming skulls and everything like that. I wanted to keep these more gothic and less kind of ghostly, if that makes sense. So, but keep that flaming idea as well. What are your opinions on Chorfs, Chaos Dwarves? Any opinions on reliable rumors indicating a full Chaos Dwarf release in Age of Sigmar for the future? See, I don't really know about rumors, because sometimes people will wish list stuff, and then other times there will actually be a rumor and it comes to fruition. I would love to see Chaos Dwarves personally. I quite like the Forge World ones, where they had the kind of the helmets that were quite like masked off, so I would like to see something in the future. I don't know if the rumors are true. I could see them being added as a faction, though. It would make sense. Are you planning on getting the Squig plushie? The Christmas one that got announced today. Yes, I might do. It's quite a nice little festive ornament. Yeah, Puppets will have some good stuff. Recently subbed to Puppets Wars Patreon, since they're making those new Bushi orcs, which are super cool. Yeah, I've seen some of their stuff popping up. It's quite nice. I've got some of their older bits for like Space Marines in my bits box somewhere. So, right, let's see. Let's see where we are with this. Okay, so we have the torso and we have this. I do apologize, person. Yeah, that, I think that might works much better. Can you see? Everyone see that? It's the trouble with dry fitting. You kind of got everything lined up. Oops. Try again. Third time's a charm. There we go. So I think that's what we're going to go for with this kind of around the front there. That works quite nicely. The actual angle of this collar here matches really nicely with this angle, so that's quite nice. I might just file it down a little bit more, just get a better fit. Quite nice. Around the back, let's see. Yeah, I thought so. I'm probably going to remove this collar here, just so I can pop that behind, but I think that'll work quite nicely. So let's get cutting it that way. Yeah, the Khorne AOS warband. Yeah, the Iron Golems has a Chaos Dwarf in there. So it's definitely still within the lore. Whether or not we'll actually get some models for it is another thing. But yeah, it would be nice to see some, like a new Chaos Dwarf faction fleshed out. In fact, speaking of dwarves, one of the things I wanted to do as my next converted army was like an old classic style dwarves army, using mainly Iron Drakes. I think I was going to do some sort of like dwarf engineer army. Probably go all out on Iron Drakes, have some converted steam tanks in there to make them look dwarven, gyrocopters and artillery pieces, and just lots of little dwarf guys. So I think that's what I'd like to do next for an army. I don't think they'll be competitive, but you never know. Lots of dwarves with cannons. It's going to be fun either way. I'll probably stick Goat Trek in there just to be on the safe side. Give me at least an element of competitiveness. Mikey Viper 407 on Twitch says, I'm doing a Sisters of Corn kill team. Currently I have a Nurgle one and is each one nice. They have some really nice kind of options for, I think I did it on this channel, it was like a more of a generic Chaos one. I can't remember if I devoted it mainly to Corn, but yeah, there's some really cool like creative stuff going on out there for Sisters of Battle who fall into Chaos. It's quite nice. Corrupted Space Marines have wax bodies. on the topic of Chaos Dwarves, there's actually quite a lot of AOS-based lore that specifically name-drop dwarves. Yeah, I think that's what they quite often do that with a lot of the Age of Sigmar stuff. I feel like they pad out a lot of the lore with stuff that they could come to in the future, and if they feel like, yeah, this is actually going to work as an army, they will do. I think quite a few factions of the newer factions have been hinted that way. So I think this little section is going to need to come down as well. It's going to need to be completely flat, this bit is. Just to make plenty of room. Obviously, the Grand Army of Cathay and Asia. Is it Cathay? Cathay. I've not actually heard it mentioned. I've only ever read it, I think, because it's one of those words I'm not sure about. But anyway, in Age of Sigmar, miniature would be amazing. They would be. The stuff that's been, like, the concept art that's been announced as part of Total Warhammer 3 is really nice. And I do hope that Games Workshop are going to be using it as a basis when they're designing the old world stuff, which I think they've said they are, especially for the Kislev stuff, so I imagine that we'll probably see a few armies coming out as a tie-in for that. There we go, it's pretty much fitting immediately. They've never hardly had to do anything there. Let's just get the file in here and just do a bit more of a smooth out, just make sure everything's nice and even. How do you avoid cutting your fingers? Yeah, these aren't even my hands. These have just got someone sat behind me in a chair just to kind of passing the hands through. So one of the things that I do to avoid cutting my fingers is use an extremely sharp scalpel, which seems counterintuitive, but anyone who's like a chef or works with knives, things like that, will actually know that sharper knives tend to cut you less because they cut more cleanly, they cut more nicely, you don't have to apply as much pressure to get a cut. So the less pressure you're working with, the more in control of the blade you are. So I actually swap this out like a completely fresh blade. I probably swap this out every couple of weeks just to make sure it's nice and sharp. And also just practice. I've been doing this for a long time and I've even got scars to one somewhere. I don't know if you can see. You can just about see that one there. That is a wargaming scar. I think most wargamers have them. Miniature builders, things like that. I've got a few more cuts there, but that's the most noticeable one. I think that's the worst one that I got, actually. I did that when I was about 13, I think. 13, 14, something like that. Currently working on Chaos Tau, focusing on Corn. Any ideas? That's interesting. Because not only have you taken Tau and Chaos and put them together, but you've also taken a very close combat god and merged them with a very unclose combat army. So yeah, I'm off the top of my head, I would say go for battle suits and just give them giant axes. Like wrap them in chains, give them giant axes, stuff like that. That'd be pretty cool. Have like skulls just kind of stuck about them, just dripping blood everywhere. That's what I'd do. Right, so let's file this down a little bit. Ben Ives, he's back. It's like the bat signal to Ben. If I do a stream, he just appears. No matter where he is in the world, he'll find a computer and he'll appear in the comment section. always here. He's just waiting. He's just constantly got my channel page open, just waiting for the live stream to start. Okay, I think that's fitting quite nicely now. So let's attach the front, and then I can always do some modifications afterwards if I need to. I just want to get this torso down, because this is like basic stuff now. I think this is probably going to be one of the biggest changes to the body. I'm not as worried about other stuff. I think this is going to be a kind of model which a lot of it comes out in the paint scheme. Where's the torso there? Bad eyes is at the window. Yeah, it wouldn't surprise me. He's either at the window or in the bath. That seems to be the going for it. Miniature builders, diorama builders, anyone that uses little knives in such a way. That's hang on. I've kind of need to catch up with the chat here. Let's go. So I went from. Convincing reality, sharper equals less likely to slip. Yep, Knights of the Abandoned Flame. Nice. I have a cut on my thumb that has nerve damage from when I was cutting the Aquila off one of the McFarlane space. Wow. I'll have to be careful. I have not done that yet, but I was probably going to... I mean, I'd probably approach it differently with one of the big kind of models just because the plastic's a different kind of plastic than this. This is quite soft plastic to work with and cut. So yeah, I'll take that as a word of warning. Where are we? Catenatus ignis, chained fire in Latin, apparently. Nice. Any chance of doing some non-Games Workshop kit bashes in the future? Love your work, but a bit fed up of Space Marines, other Space Marines, and spiky Space Marines conversions over and over. I have been doing Age of Sigmar conversions. Thank you very much. I've done plenty of them recently. I've done doing at least 4 Age of Sigmar conversions. And I've got another one that's not a Space Marine one. But yeah, the thing about kitbashing for other systems is that I think to kitbash you need to have knowledge of the system. You need to have at least a working knowledge of what works and what doesn't work, of the background. And because my knowledge is mainly focused on 40k and Age of Sigmar, coming up with good ideas to kitbash is mainly limited to those areas. I mean, it's not to say there's some quite nice like Turn Up 28 stuff, and I did actually do some filming of like a test regiment, and they came out quite nicely. I filmed them, but I had never painted them, so maybe I need to get around to doing those again. We'll see. But I do like to convert Age of Sigmar stuff. But I tend to do like full armies of those, so... Yeah. Alright, that should be okay to glue. Let's get the glue out. Let's catch up. Scroll back down. Will this chapter have studded armor? Probably not, just because I don't know where my little metal beads are to hand, so I'll leave those. Pete will be playing... where was it? Okay. Were you playing Total War Warhammer, I'm guessing. I'm just going to get some inches from it if you like it. I'm not sure what you mean by Toe. Am I missing something? Let me know. You have impeccable timing. I just got to start collecting Chaos Space Marine. I'm looking to do some... Beksinski inspired conversions. Nice. I don't know who that is, but maybe not. Side note, have you played Stargrave? No, I have not. I have not played anything apart from Age of Sigmar in probably the last 10 years. If not longer, actually. Oh, no, tell a lie. I did play Kings of War for a while. I did lie. And I do know how to play Bolt Action. But I've not played Bolt Action outside of just kind of messing around with it at home, so yeah. Passable forward, love your Sylvaneth conversions, thank you very much. Total Warhammer models are brilliant, thank you very much. I assume you mind. Pete, your face gives me Simon Pegg vibes, which is quite funny because If anyone knows the channel Ashens, everyone says that he looks like Simon Pegg. And when I did a 3D head scan and painted it up, and I'm on my Instagram, which is this guy. Look at this. This is amazing. You can actually see my face now, so you can compare it. It's not got the glasses, obviously. But a lot of people said that this looks like Stuart Ashens, which is quite funny, because Stuart Ashens looks like Simon Pegg. So, yeah, it's a bit creepy. Let's bring it nice and close in there, and you can compare it. Can we get the focus on it? So I actually had, I can't remember where they are, but I've got some really small ones, which are somewhere. So I actually made one that was really small. It's a little bit too big for Space Marines, as you can see. But I reckon if I went down like a size lower, I could make little 3D printed heads of mine. Just make a whole kill team with just my head. Oh, for the metal balls, I think they are 1mm. They're the ones that you use. I've seen some people used 0.5mm ones, which work quite well as well. So it will like have something in between. Do you ever sell your miniatures? I'd love to buy one of your fast painted Night Lords. No, I don't. I think I did sell a few of them a few years ago when I was just kind of moving around and just needed the space, really. But no, I usually end up holding on to everything. Maybe I will do in the future. If there's some stuff that's been in a box and I'm not really using it, then maybe I'll put some stuff up for sale. We'll see. Shun of the Dead kit bashing coming, maybe, yeah. Make a casualty mark with your head exploding scanner style. I could do, yeah, that's a good idea. Could be a Chaos Space Marine, euphoric from his own intellect. Where we go. Intimidate the hell out of the other player and kill team. Just an arm of yourself with different expressions. Yeah, I could do that. That'd be great. It could do that in like, and I mean, if 3D printing wasn't banned, you could maybe do an entry into like Golden Demon or something. Just to see if a whole army of just you would work nicely or not. Let's glue the leg on here as well before we get sidetracked too much by the 3D printed heads. Do you ever find yourself making bits from leftover sprue plastic? When I kitbash, I find myself literally sculpting bits with my hobby knife. Yeah, so I've used it on my Rotting Leviathan and my Necrofex Colossus videos. I use some of the sprue to make some of the wooden struts. I have used sprue for other things. I've not used it much for like kind of this size models, but for like bigger size models, I do use them. But yeah, it's like, there probably is some nice things you can do with those. Like if you go a bit more to town with, I mean, there's a guy, I forget what his name is now. A guy on YouTube who does some really nice, he basically just like literally melts down sprues and then makes them into new models and scenery and all sorts of stuff. It's like pretty cool, really, how it works. I think he uses like Tamiya plastic glue, which is basically what I've got here. So far, it's actually working quite nicely. Let's put a bit more glue in there just to help shore that up. And if I pop the front on there, yeah, this is working quite nicely indeed. That makes quite a nice circle. So what I'd probably have to do is maybe check a head fits in there. So we need to probably pick a head next. So, right. So some people said helmeted. I'm not sure if I saw anyone who said non-helmeted, so whilst I have a look at the comments, let's have wait for you guys to decide what we should go for. If you've got any ideas for heads we can use. Miniature hobbyist, that's it. Thank you, Caleb. Have you ever considered doing tuna kitbashing? Yes, I have done. I did a Biovore kitbash. Maybe I'll do more in the future. Who knows? There is a guy called Modern Synthesist on YouTube and Instagram, he does some really nice Tyranid stuff. He does a lot of sculpting, so he does some really nice Tyranid bits in there. Can you convert a firstborn model for the Executioner's High Chaplain, Thulsa Kane? I've not heard of him. Thank you for the suggestion, though. The new Spider guy from Age of Sigmar just announced would make a great Gene Sealer cult figure, maybe a Magnus. It would do indeed, yeah, because you've got those extra arms. It wouldn't take much to kind of Magnus. No. Magus. Not Magnus. Magus him up. You could probably just like put like a Gene Sealer cult's head on him. That would probably be enough. Maybe a few like symbols. Spookons are the only way to make reasonably priced 40k armor. Yeah, but the thing is, you have to actually get the sprue. So unless you can just like raid it from friends, then you have to actually collect an army to have enough sprue to build on. So we've got Flaming Skull. So the only reason why I'm not sure about you going for a Flaming Skull is because I think it might be a little bit too close to Legion of the Damned. That's the only thing I'm a bit cautious about there. Convincing Reality, thank you very much for the super chat. Specific question for you, Pete. Any advice for fixing Forge World resin bits, 30k Night Lord Terminator Claw, which has evidently had some mold slippage? Misalignment. Yeah, so it's difficult with stuff like that, because the only thing you can really do is, that I found when I've been working with resin bits, is if you sand the part down. It depends how much the slippage is. If it's only a small amount, you can usually just kind of shave it down with resin. You can probably like shave it. And then you can maybe rebuild. If it kind of ends up concaving or getting reduced too much, you can build it back out again with like a little bit of green stuff, something like that. It is a bit of a tricky job. If you can get, sometimes you can send stuff back to Forge World if it's that bad. So yeah, that's the only thing you can do. Is that a lightsaber in the background? It is a lightsaber in the background. It's also a Lego Slave One as well, and you can't see it, but there's a the Mandalorian ship as well. Is it the Razor Crest? I think it's called the Razor Crest. I can't remember. Maybe not. First time chat from Tic Tac Doe. Hi Pete, love your videos. What was your first model you kit bashed? So the first model I kit bashed that I remember was probably a. So I basically bought the old Space Marine Commander, and I brought a 5-man tactical squad of Space Marines, and I basically kit-bashed the two together. So I had a Commander and then like a 5-man squad of veterans using all the extra like components from the Commander kit. So that's probably the first kit-bash that I ever did. And that was on the advice of the guy who was running the shop. He said, if you get this kit, then you can combine them and make like two decent squads. So I was like, yeah, okay, do that. So yeah, that was like the first thing that I did. Maybe some of the Chaos Heads that have a mutation on it. I've got some. What have I got here? Let's see what I've got in my bits boxes. So let's switch to just the face camera for the time being, so we can see what's going on here. So this here is. If I reset this, oh, that's my super zoomed in look. There we go. This is a super serious question time. There we go. Okay, you can see a bit more now. You can actually see the camera. So this is my setup a little bit more easily. There you can see my Razor Crest right there. So these are the boxes that I keep all my sprues in. They're just useful boxes, and each one is separated out into a different theme. So this one is Chaos Space Marine. So I have all my Chaos sprues in here. So one of the things that I was thinking is, so I've got some of the Raptor sprues in here, which are quite nice. Dune Prince. It's probably one of my favourite sounds, just like rustling through a bits box. Blood Angels Tears helmet from Forge World. Yeah, it would have been cool. Make Headless Chaos Space Marines. I could do. Hello. I cannot read your name. Hello Eklo. There you go. Got it. Hello, Pete. You're a real source of inspiration. Thanks for all the things you do to the community. Thank you very much. And thank you very much for your comments. It's. I mean, to be honest, everyone says, I get asked, said, people say thank you, and I can't really take too much credit, because doing this is what kind of makes me want to do more stuff and want to kind of push myself with doing different conversions. I'm missing a sprue. So it's the fact that you guys support me, which means I can do a lot of the stuff that I do. The reason why I can build the big kits and have access to all this stuff is because you guys support me, the guys super chats, guys on Patreon, even the guys who just watch my videos without ad blocker on. Everything that massively helps. So thank you to every one of you, and thank you for joining me tonight. Ah, there we go. So we have the... There's one particular head that I really like and I've been wanting to use for a while. And I actually need to switch table and face, and then let's just zoom that in. That one. There we go. So this particular head here, if we can... There we go. I really like this head. I'm not sure if I'll use it though. I'm looking for something quite bland actually. It's one of those things where I know exactly what it is that I want, but I don't know which head to go for. That's an option. We'll keep that to one side. The other options are... What do we have in here? This is my Necromunda Bits box. Everything's a little bit too clean on the Palinites. House Corridor, no. House Escher. Slave Ogrins. Orlok. Vansar. No. Nothing there either. Whose lightsaber is that behind you? So, this I'll go grab it. It's actually low on battery. So this one here is... I'll switch to the... Let's switch to face camera. Let's go for... Let's talk about lightsabers for a bit. Wrong one. Okay, so this here is one from the... it's like a build-your-own one from Disney. And it's basically you get given like a bunch of individual components. And then you basically choose them. And you go in and you just like build different ones. And then it's got a kyber crystal in there as well. It's very nerdy. If you don't like Star Wars, then... So it's actually run out of batteries, but it does actually have a kyber crystal in there. You can pop that out. And you can put different coloured ones in there, and it makes the lightsaber that you put in the end different colours when it lights up. So, yeah. It's not just Warhammer I'm into. I need to put this away now. Can you convert Bretonian Knights? So I've actually looked into converting Bretonian Knights, and the reason why is because I actually really regretted not buying Bretonians when they were first... I've done this wrong. When they were first released. Because I was actually playing Warhammer when Bretonians came out, and I feel like... Well, when the plastic kits for them. And I feel like I just completely missed out on getting a hold of them. And ever since then, I've really regretted it, and then they just stopped making them. But there is a company, I think Highland Miniatures, on... they're on Patreon, and you see them on Facebook quite a lot. And they've basically done a whole bunch of 3D printable files for, like, knights and stuff, which is pretty cool. So maybe in the future I'll do something for them. But yeah, it would be nice to do some Bretonian knights. I'm hoping they actually get released when we actually see a... when we see the old world return. So yeah, this is sort of... it's very similar to I think this kind of cowl bit is very similar to Anakin's. Anyway, enough about Star Wars. Let's go back to this, shall we? Let's zoom in twice and then switch the table and face the color. This little deck here is really nice. I actually got I was really fortunate because Elgato, the guys who do these and like face cameras, and I already use like the cam link so I can use my camera, and they got in touch and said, oh, is there anything that you want to kind of help out with your stream setup? I was like, I want a stream deck, please. So they sent me this, and you basically just program all these buttons, and I can basically switch these, and it just does whatever I need to. So yeah, quite happy with that. which is why I'm doing a stream, because I want to test it all out. They also give me the face cam as well, which is why I've got two. Right, so anyway. Could you do some sculpted flames with empty eye sockets like the entire head is engulfed? Yep, I could do that. Would be nice. What about plain faceless head, since they're left behind? That's nice. I quite like the idea that it's all been burnt off as well. Goliath heads with the mohawk shaved off always look like rough and tough space marines. They do. It looks really nice as one of my... what have I used it for recently? I've used one of the Goliath heads and they're really nice. Jalapeno pepper for the head. Yeah, could do. Bretonians are an army I do kind of miss. They had an interesting super retro flavor. Yeah, it's like... It's one of those things where... They had this... They were very generic. They were very generic fantasy. They were basically just based off French knights and had like a little bit of Arthurian legend mixed in there. But then... I'm guessing it was just because they wanted something that they could brand a little bit more strongly, which is a shame because I really like the peasants and then the kind of knights aesthetic. This like really stock, basic, simplistic battle line and these really elite kind of hard-hitting cavalry is a nice option. I think it would have worked really well in Age of Sigmar, but alas, they've gone. Emperor's Children would be a great option for the heads. Maybe. No eyes. You're by far my favourite mini hobbyist YouTuber. Simple, creative, encouraging. Keep up the great work, man. Thank you, Alex. Appreciate it. Thumbs up. I can do thumbs up. I can look at everyone and be sincere now. Thank you. Thank you very much. Chad Lowe, fancy Warhammer. Yeah, definitely. I do like Age of Sigmar. I just think it needs a little bit more, like, down-to-earth stuff in there as well. Just kind of balance out some of the high concept stuff that's going on. Half thought of doing an Auric Warband in a similar theme. Some others were making Auric Knights from Iron Jaws, Plague Knights bits from Auric, but that's quite nice. I think someone mentioned that to me before, actually, and it would be kind of cool, because they're quite armoured, aren't they? So in a way you could make them like a pseudo-Bretonian army. Nice idea. I do like that. I need an army of Space Marines all in Blood Knight Year colours, yeah. I think I've seen that, don't you? It's very nice. You could have a helmet that's melting. It could do, just get... Actually, just put this under a flame, melt ahead. Will the marine include some dead animal bits? Someone did actually mention that, and I have got some, I think, that I could probably use to hand. So, yeah, we'll maybe go for that. Flaming animal skull, maybe. Could do. Could do a bit of sculpting. Is there any army that you're particularly looking forward to other than Bretonians, new or returning for the old world? That's it. Thank you. I looked at it, I was like, Total Warhammer? The Old World, yeah. So basically, I would really like to see Classic Bretonnia coming back. That's like the one thing. If they announce Bretonnia, I think they've kind of hinted at it. They've released some maps, and you can see some of the heraldic shields over the lands of Bretonnia, so it'd be really nice to see those. But yeah, I'd go for that one. But yeah, even just, like you said, just regular orcs would be nice too. Have you ever thought about doing a video about a top 10 bits? I'm curious to know what kits you recommend. That's a good idea. Top 10 kits for bits, I probably do, because there's some bits are good, but they're very specific, but some kits are very generic. Might give Age of Sigmar a chance once they release some City of Sigmar models that are not just the old stuff. It would be nice. It would be nice to have to. Right, anyway. Let's choose a head. So there's one head that I actually really like. I don't know if it will work, though, but... It's one of my favourite. Speaking of top 10 favourite kits, where is it? That's fine. Before I reveal this, I don't think you can see it now. You can't see it. So I'll give 10 internet points. So anyone who guesses which kit I'm looking at currently, bearing in mind I've said it's one of my favourite kits. So go. First person gets 10 points. Skaven, no. Skulls, no. Flagellants, no. Chef Boyardee, you got it. It is the Mark III kit that I'm looking at. Congratulations, you know me so well. I'm looking for the... This is it. This guy here, right? So this head, this one here, I hope it focuses. This one is a really kind of chunky head, and I just don't know. There's always something about it that I quite like. how simplistic it is. But what I was thinking was going for this head, even though it being like quite a bland head, when I come to paint it, it's making the whole thing just glow, so that, there is a, it's almost like he's burning up from the inside. I'm trying to think of, I suppose the closest thing I can imagine is the villains from Iron Man 3, the, I forgot his name, the main villain, the main, is it Killian something? And he has like, he's got like kind of energy that's like burning up from inside him, and it's like burning up from underneath the skin. So that's what I quite like to do. They've got this like maybe chaos fire. So it's not so much the conversion, it's more the painting side which does it for this. So that's what I had in mind, basically. Eldritch Killian, thank you. Extremis. A gene seed problem where they burst into flame when they die. That's actually a really nice idea. Like when they get like really angry, that actually works really well. They kind of just, their metabolism like kicks into overdrive, and then they suddenly kind of just burn. Red Lotus 101, you may be onto something here. Oh, there's been some really good ideas in the chat, and I feel really bad for not going with those ideas, but this, I think I'm going for, I'm committing here. I'm committing to this one. I'm going for this. Actually, let's cut this off for now. We'll cut that to one side, and then I'm going to have a quick look just to see if there's any other chaos space marines. I've got some Havoc somewhere. Let's see if I can... So another thing, if I just switch to the face cam, and then I reset the camera. No, I always keep pressing that one. That's the reset button. So these cabinets here is where I keep a lot of my stuff. I don't think the microphone. So I'm going to probably not be able to hear me, but I'm just going to have a look in one of the cabinets because I think there's a lot of some stuff in here. So I do have some Havoc somewhere, but I'm not actually sure where they are. So where were they? When did I last used them on my Huron Blackheart? Where would they go? Since you wish to paint the head like burning from the inside out, can it be an ex-salamander or something like that? That's nice. That's a nice idea. Like some sort of salamander successor chapter that's maybe gone rogue. That could work very well. On the floor underneath the desk. Been working on... It's actually... No, unfortunately, it's one of those things that just like drops off and doesn't fall, I'm afraid. Been working on a team of Gravis Armor Chaos conversions here. Counts as Grey Knights kill team. That's nice. I think one of the things I was quite happy with was the fact that my Grey Knights kill team, I think if I remember rightly, is still legal, if I read correctly, on the actual what's the book? Actually, there might be in another cupboard. No. Okay, we'll leave it. We'll leave it now. That's really annoyed me. There was one more place it might be. Bear with me. I do apologize for disappearing. Horik tipped £3. Thank you very much, Horik. I appreciate it. If anyone else has tipped, I do apologize if I haven't noticed it, but thank you very much. I do appreciate anyone who's been supporting me in the stream and in other streams as well, so thank you very much. So basically, it was this particular sprue that I wanted. I quite like the head that comes with this guy. It's like a bit of an angry face. I think it kind of has that expression that I'd want, where it's like all burning up. Probably take the top off just to be on the safe side. Glowing from metabolic process is a very interesting concept. Could play on excess voraciousness. Yeah, I think this is why I like having these like live streams with you guys, because it kind of gives me, there we go, there's the head. Oh, it's not a shouty actually. It's a shoutier head. A few heads in this sprue. I think I may have used the other head on one of my other conversions. It's possibly why it's missing from in here. I think it's quite a nice head though. It's kind of fairly straightforward. I take the top knot off. I probably will keep this separate, because if I actually paint this as well, then I want to make sure this is like separated from the rest of it. So let's snip that head off, and then we can work with that. Keeps it on chaos theme as well. I found out. I was kind of disappointed in myself that my organisational skills had left me with a kit that I didn't know where the location was. It's one of the things I pride myself on, knowing a lot about. So let's get this guy cleaned up nice and quickly. This is the only trouble with doing live stream, right? You can actually probably see like what goes into making a video if after what, an hour and 10 minutes. I know I've been talking, but an hour and 10 minutes. This is all I've done. I've basically built a body and put a grill on it. That's it. Oh, man. That's pretty much why I ended up going a little bit silent over September. Was it September? Yeah, kind of late August, early September. I didn't really post any videos for a while just because I was working on my Sylvaneth and it was just taking so long to do it. And I had to have a deadline of 11th of September to get it done, because that's when the tournament was, and I just felt like all I was doing was just converting Sylvaneth, which is probably why I haven't picked him up again. I would like to add some new units to it, but maybe I'm going to give it a little bit of time just before I come back to it, because I felt like I maybe burnt myself out with that a bit. Planning on doing that Badab project that's been going on lately, and was wondering what parts you would use to make the special Astral Claws captain with the sword and storm shield and servo arm bolter. So I think that you'd probably need to use something from a Tech Marine kit, most likely either the Primaris one or the Iron Hands character. That would be a good option. Some pretty good kind of servo arm bolters that you can use from there, or like weaponry. You can probably do something really nice based on like a blade guard and just kind of chaos it up a little bit, I guess. I think Astral Claws are the chaos ones, aren't they? If I remember rightly. Ben, I just want to see you slice your fingers on a live stream. I'm actually probably more careful on a live stream than I am normally, just for that reason, because I don't want to sit here and just like, I do actually have like a kitchen towel nearby though, just in case. Right, okay, so I think that works quite well in there. I'm going to cut off the top knot, and then if I attach this front grill as well. So the only thing, I wouldn't want to kind of go something too crazy with this head. It's why I'm thinking of doing something like really kind of bright and glowing, because once it's behind these kind of these grills, then it ends up being hard to see the details, but if you make it like really nice and bright and you can kind of see it through there, you can do some nice OSL effects and make it stand out. So I think going for a fairly simple head and relying on the painting to bring it out is a good option there. The concept reminds of him bursting into flames reminds me of an in-universe chapter called The Flame Falcons, who were known to burst into flames when in battle. I've not heard of them, actually. I'll have to have a look at them up. So I'm not going to glue this into place just yet. What I might do is just kind of fix it into place temporarily for now. Oh, let's drop that a little bit in there. Where are we on the comments? Rico-matic, hey, Peach wants to drop in and say you have a real grade A Discord. Lots of help, Rose, in there. I'm still a noob, and I got some really good advice when I posted my mini. Yeah, I think this is the kind of thing. We just wanted to have like a Discord, which was... I don't appear in there as often as I would like to, just because I'm usually busy doing other things, and I try not to get myself sidetracked with... because I could just go in there and start talking for hours about conversions if I let myself, but... so this is the thing now, right? We've got to be a little bit careful because we might have to angle this down a little bit forward, so it's more of it kind of sticks out a little bit more like that, because you can see already how close this would be, and I feel like he'd just be like constantly like catching his nose on the front of it. So let's work on angling that down a little bit more there. This is why it's always good to do dry fits. So let's pop that there, because I think this guy's going to be standing like that, so the head needs to be kind of angled upwards a bit more like that. So I should also mention, if you haven't done so already, join the Discord. Discord should be in the description below. I can't remember if it's still in there. If it's not, I'm sure one of the Discord members in that, hopefully, I know Kabuski's in the Discord, someone might be kind enough to share a link. So if you haven't done so already, join on that. You don't need to be a patron to join it. A lot of people in there just join and want to come along and say hello, basically. So don't worry too much about, like, I think we do have like a Patreon like only little section in there, but yeah, I don't want to have like a completely lockdown one. So if you're interested in chatting with people who like wargaming, like my stuff, like converting and anything like that, then feel free to join. Right. Surprised Pete doesn't have a shrine to the paint thinner in the background. Maybe I do, maybe I just put it down. Maybe it's from one of those cupboards. I just open it up and it all kind of glows. It is there, I just joined. Thank you, Marvel313. Say hello, and I'm sure people will welcome you with open arms. Hey, Pete, do you think you would ever do an Imperial Chaos Knight conversion or convert any other Titan-like vehicle? So I did have an idea for doing one of the Adeptus Titanicus scale Titans and making some like kind of Nurgle Knight at one point. So still in there. Still got the bits for it, so we'll see. Maybe we will do in the future. Are there any gratuitous close-up pictures of your hands in there? Not yet. That's on my $100 tier Patreon. You basically get a weekly shot of my hands, just caressing a model like that. That's a freebie. let's sort this out now. Let's angle this down. So what we need to do is we need to. So to get this angling forward, we need to make this surface here flat. So we need to make it more like this. So if we run a file at the angle that we want it to be, it should actually work. We'll see. Only hands. Yeah. Just for people who want to see the hands of wargaming YouTubers. Thanks for the ideas. For the Corn Tau I have right now, I've been using the Spiked Fist from the AOS Blood Warriors on the free hand of the Stealth. That actually works really well because they have kind of like quite an armored fist. Certainly the stealth teams do. This is what I like about converting, because it kind of, you can go against the grain really and really do something a bit more interesting. How's work? Yeah, it's good. Still working from home, so it's quite nice. Yeah, it's all good. Web development's all one of those industries that never really kind of, it usually does okay, especially in the last 12 months we've been okay. So I've been one of the fortunate ones, really. Not to worry too much. Just been working from home. It's been nice to be at home a bit more. Sounds like a 12-month calendar waiting to happen. The hands of wargaming YouTubers. So in that case, which month would I be? There's your... Kabuski, hey Pete, I was similar looking to you. That should be good. Do you have any suggestions for digibashes? Ooh. So this is the thing, isn't it? Because it's like, it's something I've recently definitely seen the value in, because one of the things, I mean, I'm not great at drawing. I used to be able to draw when I was younger, but I kind of just completely lost. I got into Warhammer, basically, and just stopped practicing and learned how to paint miniatures instead. So I kind of would like sometimes to have a way of getting the ideas that I've got in my head into more of a like a prototype phase. And I think the digibashes are really good for that. But like my skills are a little bit more limited than the stuff that you put out. But yeah, I think there's probably some ideas actually that I've had that work quite nice. Like it really depends what it is that at the time. I mean, I've got like a list of stuff. Let's grab out my list of ideas that I've had. I have a Google Doc which has got all ideas on there. Some of them I haven't actually updated it for a while. Video ideas, 15th of July. Let's have a look at this. Okay, so I'm going to show this on the stream because it's quite interesting actually. So some of these things I have done and some of these things I haven't done. So can we see those? So I've got my so basically what I do is if I have like an idea, I put down like a little bit of a title and then just some notes to kind of help me out. So I had a kind of an idea of doing for Thunder Warriors. Everyone suggests Thunder Warriors and that's probably what I do. I had an idea for doing some like Cities of Sigmar using the new orcs. I forgot what they're called. So this is actually an idea that I had. Speaking about Bretonnians, was that I kind of wanted to do if you've played the Warhammer Total War games and remember from the old Bretonnian stuff, there was a Lyonesse, which was like a Joan of Arc kind of character. And I was going to basically use Yndrasta from Age of Sigmar and kind of sculpt that into a model. And then I was going to blend into doing some sort of like Bretonnians reforged as Stormcast Eternals, maybe like the new dragon mounts. Tusker Demon Killer, that was another idea that I had working on. I kind of put that to one side for a while. So the Viacos Duke Vampire. If you've played Resident Evil Village, then you may recognize where I'm going with the Duke. Lego Warhammer, that was an idea I had a while ago and never really got around to doing anything with it. Dark Mech stuff, Cultists, some Dark Eldar, some Tau Paramount Guvesa, Human Guvesa, Hardcore Tower? Question mark. That's basically going to like do some like battered armor and extra equipment, things like that. Necron Scavenger Cults, Gorse Cult, lots of like energy fields, things like that. Some Imperial Guard regiments, so I actually did do Praetorians, I did a video on those. Feudal, I did do them on a live stream. And then I had some kind of ideas for different Stormcast Eternals, and actually did these. These were some of the ones that I was planning on doing last year, but I never got around to them. So yeah, that's my little ideas box. So if you've got any ideas from there, Kabiski, then feel free to bash some of those together and send them my way, and I will see about including them. Anyway, what Cruel Boys, that was it. Someone just mentioned it. Ooh, have we, where was I? It's more in depth than the stuff I have to do for uni. Cruel Boys, Hogwarts. The New Orcs are called Cruel Boys if you're talking about Adrius. Yes, I was talking about those. How much bits do you have? I have a lot of bits, like so many bits. I mean, I have these. So let's just switch to the face cam and then reset that on. So these boxes here, I have about 9 or 10 of these boxes, these size, and these are basically just filled with sprues. The cupboards that you see behind me, I have, so there's a few kits in that cupboard there. The middle cupboard hasn't got any kits in, but those, the ones on the far right, they're filled with kits. I also have a few kits in a drawer down here, and I have big useful boxes filled with other kits, and I also have like a cupboard as well at the top of the stairs. Yeah, I've got a lot. As I think Ben said earlier, I'm a hoarder. But it's basically because I don't actually always know what kit I'm going to be using. So quite often when like a patron comes in, I'll go and buy a few kits for ideas that I've had. And even if I don't use them at the time, then I will go and I've got that option then from the future. So if I have an idea, I can go, right, I need that part. And I don't have to wait a few days or like a week or so to get a hold of it. So yeah, I have quite a lot of stuff. Right, anyway, that's this guy. Let's just file down that little bit of the chest a little bit, just to give a bit more space here. I think this has probably been the most sidetracked live stream that I've done for a while. I think it's because I've got the face camera. I feel like there's a whole different dimension that I can work with now. Okay, let's just scrape down those a little bit more. So whilst I'm doing this, if you have any ideas for weapons that we can maybe give this guy, then leave those and we can start kind of brainstorming those, figure out what we're going to give this guy. Definitely going to be close combat related, I think. I want a nice open pose for him, so I think we need to go for something a little bit more melee orientated. Cool. Okay, there we go. We can have this weird kind of crazy headdress going on there, so that's quite kind of what I had in mind, so I'm glad it's come out so far. Where have we got? I have a small conversion bits question. I'm a big fan of Iron Hands fan. I'm a big Iron Hands fan and want to convert some marine bionics for kill team. How would you make them with cheap materials? So if you watch my Iron Hands video, you can see on there that I used some plastic rod, and it's very easy to get a hold of it, and you can use that very easily. And you can basically get a Space Marine arm, cut away the wrist, cut away at the elbow, and just replace that forearm or upper arm or anything they want, just with rods of plastic, and it just works really nicely for bionics. Where are the cage birds from? The cage birds are from the... under a pile of stuff. the Cord. Why was I showing it that way? There you go. Cordor Redemptionist. Look at this. I can use my zoom mode now. The Cordor Redemptionist. There we go. What about Chainsword? There's some. You know what? Actually, someone's saying Chainsword. There is a really nice. I think it's called. Yes, I knew I had a spare one. This thing. Look at that. It's basically a chainsword with a flamethrower in it. I reckon I could give that a Space Marine. Like, it would be huge, but it would be so worth it. What about like a fist? Like a chain fist kind of thing. That would work quite well. Flamethrower chain fist. Reminds me of Chaos Warbands from the Realm of Chaos books, first edition War 40k, Fancy Battle. It was a recommended kind of gaming. Yeah, the Realm of Chaos book was quite nice. I had a look at some of the PDFs that people put online, and some really nice inspiration stuff in there. Would you ever do Stormcast Eternal character conversions in future, like how you do Space Marine ones, such as your hero on Blackheart? Quite possibly, yeah. Again, it's just a matter of knowing about the lore. I don't have quite as in-depth knowledge about the characters in there, so yeah, maybe in the future if I find some like interesting characters, maybe from some of the books and things like that. Flamethrower chainsaw thing, yeah, let's go for that, shall we? That's a nice big flamethrower. Let's cut that off the sprue. This kit is just providing some really nice stuff for this conversion. Let's go for that. Stupid thing is, though, the only thing I'm going to say is, because of Necromunda, a slightly bigger scale than, like, I mean, it still works with the stuff, but it's of ever so slightly bigger scale. So if you actually look here, I've got a Chaos Space Marine, but the arm, it sort of works in scale with it. If you look there, I could literally just give him this whole thing. Don't think I will. Maybe I will. I've lost the kit. Where's the kit gone? There. Right. So, maybe there is something in here we can use. So, there we go. So, this kit has a lot of these kind of arms, and where there's like just an arm and like a hand, we can possibly use the arms for like that would use holding a bolter. Yeah, we could maybe grab one of the arms that I'm using a bolter like this or something and just modify that so it's holding this instead. I think that's an option. We can see that. Marcel Sazbol. I can't pronounce you. Thank you, Marcel. I do appreciate. If you book some spare bed, dead animal bits, thank you very much. Very appreciated. Where was I? Yeah, I think we're gonna go for that one. Maybe keep the big leather glove. Good luck. Possibly, yeah. Sounds good. You can keep the necromunda arm and put a pauldron of the giant spike, keeping it in place. Yeah. I'm liking it. It's my alarm to feed the cat. Right, he's got tablets. It's medication. Right. Let's go for one of these arms. Let's get the instruction book up to see which arms are going to work best. So there's some special weapons arms, but I'm kind of reluctant to use those ones because if I actually want to do some conversion work later on in using these, then yeah, maybe not. Let's go for one of the more generic arms. I know I said they wanted to keep the pose quite open, but, you know. So I'm looking for an arm that is being held a little bit lower, ideally. This one might work. this really nice kind of bolter on, because I could use the one, because there's no other hand on the bolter, I could clip away the bolter and then, yeah, that might work actually. Five is being used quite low. Yeah, that could work too. So many options here. Let's go for 15. Let's go for that one. Feed the cat. He's actually got like he's got like a heart condition, so he's got like a heart murmur, and he has to have like medication every day. But he's the most kind of awkward cat. You've got to we give him like this paste. It's like a liver paste, like a pate for cats. And if you give it to him, you can only get about halfway down the tube, and then he decides he doesn't like it anymore. And he wants a fresh tube. So he's just one of those kind of like really overly fussy cats. All right, so let's check this. I think if that goes there, that's holding it, I reckon, low enough. Try not to knock off the cate pate. That's exactly what I'm going to be using it for. It's a great name for it. Okay. How does this not work with the... that's why. Okay. So I'm thinking if we do this, and... So yeah, the hand is a little bit smaller. The leather glove would look nice, but I think it would look a bit maybe strange against that. A little bit... maybe a bit too much of a delicate wrist there. So let's go for... Let's cut this off here. Cut away the hand. I'm going to keep these little bits because why not? Cut this off here, and we can basically glue that on, and then we can figure out the other arm when we come to it. Let's go for it. Okay. Let's cut this off first. So I'm going to use my knife for this bit because it's going to be a struggle to get my clippers in this bit without damaging the arm too much, because the arm's quite a nice component to keep. So you never know, Ben, you might get your bleeding on camera soon. Don't normally like to cut like this, but sometimes needs must. Okay. Have we got a free arm? Than that. Yay, we did it. No bloody either, which is always a good sign. You know, so how much quieter I went then when I was concentrating on the knife. I was like, I gotta make sure I don't slice my finger off on a live stream. You never know, it might work, it might get me some views. There's some national press notice. Man slices his own finger off on live stream. Blood for the blood god. I have a slight feeling these guys are pyromaniacs. Yeah, I think that's kind of where we end up heading with this. It's like these guys just like fire. And just destroying, not in like the noble, respectful way that like salamanders use fire. These guys just are literally on fire. They're setting things on fire. They're setting each other on fire. Pretty much anything that'll burn. And if it don't burn, it'll cover it with something that does burn and burn that. One new viewer just caught. Does that mean if I did slice my finger, I get like a super chat from Korn? That'd be quite nice. Korn super chatted. Blessed by the god. Question for later, and I do apologize if this has been asked before. Are you planning on doing some Chaos Ad Mech at some point? It's always one of those things that's in my head. There is always those options. Like, it's one of those kind of factions which is very nice and ripe for conversions. But it's just getting around to it, really, because there's always other ideas. I've got an idea in my cupboard that I can't say anything about, because it's secret, that will be coming out in hopefully about 2 weeks' time. No, a week's time, hopefully. Maybe longer, we'll see. So that's what I've got for that. I've got another project which I'm kind of working on as well, quite a big project. And I've got just so many ideas, just not enough time to do them all, which is a shame. Okay, that's clean enough. Let's free this hand from this bolter. I'm not as fussed about keeping the bolter because I have quite a few of these. Well, might as well. In for a penny, in for a pound. Quite an easy cut to make this one is. So we'll see. We'll risk it again. We're going to see. The trick is here not to apply too much pressure and just do a few cuts. And once you get your first ones in, it's not too bad because you kind of end up creating a path for your later cuts to go down. So this one is a little bit trickier, but if we just do a few light cuts and just scour them in. This nerve-wracking tension. Let's go for tension. Need some sound effects now. This isn't cutting as well as I thought. Oh, there we go. You can see it kind of separating out now. Ah, so this arm is being held on a bit. Actually, there's a pipe there. That's what I missed. There you go. Nice. You can tell it's a secret. We won't say anything. Unfortunately, this video is going to go onto YouTube afterwards, and it will be said by to a lot of people who won't keep the secret, I'm afraid. But the only thing I can say is a conversion, which doesn't narrow it down much, but it's a conversion, and I'm making something very different out of something else. That's all I can say. I've already said too much. Right, I don't know why I'm scraping that down, because I'm not using that, I'm using the arm. Let's go for... scrape off the hand there, just to make sure we've got a nice fit. And hopefully this should fit quite nicely against here. I'm guessing there might be a little bit, yeah. So this little bit of trigger guard needs to be adjusted just because the hand is slightly longer. I'm just going to file down some of these knuckles as well. Silver Scratch Build, if you want to join the Discord, there should be a link in the description, I believe. Yeah, you're on YouTube, yes. There should be a link down there. You should just follow that, and you should be in the Discord. Do you want my paint-to-paint to work well? I had a bad experience with a pink color that I brought from that brand. I've always been okay with them. I think the only thing with army paints that you need to do is make sure you shake them very well, because they have a tendency of separating in the bottle. If you have some like those like shakers, then you can drop some of those in the bottles, and that massively helps to mix them up. But yeah, they're usually okay, as long as you just shake them, make sure they're nice and mixed before you use them. Working out, I'm trying to like... I was worried that I was working out a shot here, and then I start like creeping up, and eventually I'm just like over there. I need to like draw out an area that's like a safe area. Right, let's see how this is going here. So I think I need to trim the bottom of that off as well. Perfect. Tom Kenish, thank you very much. Watching your stuff gave me the confidence to start hacking plastic myself. You're welcome. It's one of those things where you can end up destroying stuff. I mean, you can end up breaking parts, and when you've got a kit which has got only one of the part that you need, you have to be very careful because you can end up wasting a lot of time and money very easily. So I think sometimes having somebody else who's done it before you show you how to do it and say, yeah, that idea is actually going to work. This is actually going to work for what you wanted to do. Do this, don't do that, blah, blah, blah. It kind of helps people just get that initial confidence it needs to just start messing around with things itself. And there's some like really cool conversions out there, and some conversions don't even need to be that adventurous, but they can be really effective all the same. So yeah. Stick a sheet of paper on there or something. Yeah, I think I did have a like tape originally, but it kind of annoyed me because when I was filming the videos for the other stuff, I had to remove the tape because I sometimes film higher or low depending on what I'm filming. Let's bend those in a little bit more. So the only thing I've done is I've made this a little bit too so the hand, you can see there, I mean, hopefully it focuses in nicely enough. Yeah, you can see that it's not quite, I've made it a little bit too small. I probably shouldn't have clipped the handle off fully. So if I stick it up to the top here, it doesn't really, there's a gap at the bottom and vice versa, and in the middle there's a gap either end. So let's grab some plasticard. Okay, I think this is my 1mm one. It should be good. Cool. Let's attempt just to drill a hole through there and basically make a new handle. Didn't keep checking the fit as you went. Exactly. That's, I should have followed my own advice. I always say, check the fits so you're not making too many cuts, but no. Although, to be fair, this does give me an excuse to get my pin vise out and do some drilling, so it's not all bad. Not all bad. Okay, let's just go. I just wanted to drill a hand. That's all I wanted to do. Just an excuse to do this, to make a new handle. Actually, I'm tempted to make a drill a hole all the way through there and then link up the hand. Oh yeah, I'm gonna do that. Then it looks like I intended to do it all along, and not that I just made a mistake. This is the great thing about editing the videos afterwards, because like on a live stream, you can see that I've just made a mistake. I'm like, ah, crap. But on a video, I can say, oh yeah, all along I intended to make a new handle for this. So I drilled out the hand and drilled out the flamer just to make this handle that looks like it was more of a proper handle rather than just this random one that we've added in. And then you guys are none the wiser. And I look good. When actually I just made a mistake. So what I'm trying to say is my fraud. It's all lies. Okay, so if I put that there and I drill kind of just about there should be enough. There you go. And do the same just below. Do we make it even? There we go. Oh man, we've got some spammers. Let's get rid of this. Bye bye. Remove. And let's report. Bye. Okay. Remove. 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 Okay. Just when I was drilling holes. That's all I wanted to do. Joe G. Pete just came to say, please do more bolt action painting tutorials. Have to work now. Yes, I do have some plans for some, so keep an eye out for those. I've actually got some Flames of War stuff coming soon as well, so again, keep an eye out for those. Right, hopefully. So the good thing about this is if I actually don't line everything up properly, it's not a problem because I can just modify. Yeah, let's just trim that back a little bit. Isn't working as well as I thought it would. It's one of those things where it seems really, I think, yeah, it's actually because this plastic rod is ever so slightly wider, even though it's supposed to be 1 millimeter, it's ever so slightly bigger than the drill bit is, so it doesn't go all the way through, so you kind of have to widen the hole a little bit. Inquisitive Pete, the wargamer, has purged his chat of the taint of Slaanesh as he's drilling through. Maybe, yeah, maybe not all this kind of this suggestive putting rods into holes is what summoned them. Here's me talking about summoning corn into the chat, and then I go and summon something very, very different. Okay. This isn't working. There we go, I got it. It's not working. So the problem is that finger is protruding too much. So, okay, let's. This is supposed to be a simple thing. This is supposed to be something really simple, straightforward that I could just quickly do, and no, never that way. I've noticed recently you're basically exclusively using ProAcryl. Is it just that they're that much better? Basically, I've just really enjoyed using them. They're kind of the paints that I like to use. I like to use paints that are a little bit more higher pigment or have quite like vivid colours, and they have all that I need, which is basically why I'm using them. It's not to say they're the best paints in the world. Some people might not like them. Some people might prefer like smoother paints, but yeah, quite enjoyed using them recently. Okay. trimmer. Hopefully it's going to do something. Someone is about to lose a finger. No. Not yet. Let's try again. Yeah, it's going to be interesting actually to see what the Duncan Rhodes line of paints are going to be like. I guess it's going to be something that he personally quite likes in paints, but anything that allows you to do thin coats, I guess. Maybe they'll be slightly pre-thinned or something. I don't know. We'll see. So that hole needs to be a bit bigger. That's why we're not getting any. Perfect. So the handle actually works really well. If I bring it in sharp, there we go. But getting the hand and the handle to line up properly isn't working as well as I wished. So it works well there, but then when I actually put it in here, are we doing it? I think we're doing it, guys. Very close anyway, at least. Still just a little bit too... Not quite there. Right. There's actually going to be no hand left. It's going to end up being like a bionicle hand before long. We'll see. I'm kind of determined to get this to work now. It's a matter of principle. Oh, very close. Can we make it last a little bit? No. Very, very close though. We're getting there. Literally like a fraction of a millimeter away. Yes, I think we might have it. Whew. The most frustrating part of this entire build has been getting two pieces of plastic rod to line up. It shouldn't be this hard. So I apologize, I've gone off camera a little bit here because it's kind of really fiddly to get to that last little bit of the hand. I'm giving up. This is just not going well. It's just like I'm lined up with the hole, but it just doesn't want to go through. I feel like maybe this bit of the plastic needs to be a little bit wider. Let's just widen this out and then fill out with some plastic. Let's try the other way. Oh, we've got it. Yes. Right, okay. That took a lot longer than I anticipated. Was it worth it? I don't think so. Well, I kind of thought that this conversion would be done by now, but it seems to have taken a lot longer than I initially thought it did. So it's been a bit of a slow burn. Yeah, no pun intended. So I think this arm here goes quite nicely, and we can possibly get another hand either holding it, or I can maybe do something with pointing. I'm going to keep this kind of hinge that I've got going on here, just because it's going to make it easier to pose where this goes. So let's work on a second arm and see what options we've got. Right, okay. Left arm. I could just cheat and just use like a pointing arm or something, just use like a knife arm. What arms have we got? Chainsword arms? I could use one of those. Double chainsword. So the only problem with these hands is they don't actually have another hand attached to them, which makes it a bit more difficult to do that. This is the arm that was intended to be used with the particular bolter that I've used, but then obviously it's kind of missing part of the hand. Tricky. Very tricky. There might be something in the Havoc sprue. Let's check to see if there's anything in there that we can use. So I need to just double check. So in this kit there are two missile launchers. No, there's a missile launcher, it's actually this hand here. It's like the rocket launcher arm that they use, like for the guy who's carrying like the rocket launcher. That, where is it? That guy? That might be a good arm to use. Pop it down there like that, and then have this arm across, and then the arm. Can hold on to it on this little handle bit here. There we go. So if I attach that arm like that and then bring this one around and then bend that in a little bit. Might need to adjust the arm a bit just to get it to angle that I want it to, but I can possibly get something going like that. Let's make a few modifications. Yeah, let's go for that. This is a bit more familiar territory now, this is, so Hopefully this will be a little bit quicker. Havuka. An Inquisition Quill team. Yeah, because I did my Auto Kronos, didn't I, last year. So yeah, it would be quite nice to do an Inquisitorial Kill team. You could probably use the Kill team rules for the Krieg, because they have like all the specialists and stuff. You could probably get some good options out of that. Build another handle. Yeah, maybe I will. Maybe I will, maybe I won't. We'll see. We'll see where we are with this first. I may pop myself off handles for life. So I think we need to angle this in a little bit more, if I remember rightly. So if we bring this in here, then we bend this around a little bit. Just wrapping around the body. Then yeah, that. So the moment the arm as it sits flat against the surface is more like that, and we basically need it to fit more like that. So we need to essentially cut this section here off, make this angle less like that, more like this. Basically, I do apologize for the technical jargon I use there, but sometimes it's got to be done. The things are back. I thought I'd hide user on this. No. Okay. Perfect. There we go. The bot came back. See how we're going here. So the angle's still quite. I'm tempted just to kind of glue this into place now, just so I've got something to work against that's a bit more solid. I think at the moment it's very difficult to do the lining up and actually get everything working. So I'm going to get this arm and fixed in place, and then I'm going to bend around the other arm accordingly. So let's hold that for a few seconds. So, yeah, so for the base of this model, I'm just using a Chaos Space Marine. Very, very simple, just regular Chaos Space Marine, nothing fancy. So far, we've used some parts from the Havox kit. We've used some parts from the Cordor Redemptionist as well. That's what we're going for. And for anyone who hasn't already seen it, here's the model that we're kind of using as like a rough mock-up, which is basically what the style I was going for here. There's still a couple of items like the shields I wanted to add in a little bit more. But I think we've got there with the head. That's definitely what we wanted. So yeah, let's carry on. Okay. So that arm's in place permanently, so I can better see the angle of this now. So the arm itself probably needs to be, I think the angle that way isn't too bad. It needs to be angled a little bit more that way, and then I can possibly stick it onto the arm. Just fudge it and put it on. Yeah, could do. I have done that before. There's been a few conversions where I've just been like, yeah, okay. You can't see it. We'll just cover it with armor. If you can't see it, it doesn't exist. He just kind of looks like he's just like waving his fist angrily at the opponents. He's just like, come over here. The arm. And why is the arm going further away? I'm trying to like increase the angle here, but it's just like making it worse. What's going on? That's. The great thing about Space Marines is that, like someone says, the shoulders pads that you put on there can hide a multitude of sins when it comes to converting. So don't be afraid to cut the arms a little bit shorter if you need to, and you can place them a bit lower, but you don't really notice because of the shoulder pads. It's always good. Okay, we're getting a bit closer now. If I angle this down a little bit, there we go. It was just that the arm was a bit too high. So what I might do is because this is just going to be easy, I might just put a handle through. Put the arm a little bit lower, maybe just make it one more adjustment cut just down here, just to blend that arm into the torso a bit more. And then I'll do another hand drilling, and then add another little bit of plastic rod. And that can be bent around a bit more. There we go. Perfect. So, let's drill this hand again. Well, not this hand, but drill hand A again. Orc converting, when I just slap random plates all over it. Pretty much, I mean, orcs pretty much convert as a way of life. Which is kind of ironic because I don't actually convert many orcs on this channel, but yeah. I've been doing a lot of conversion work lately, even some pinning. It's what I like to hear. Everyone needs to do a bit of pinning in the life. So we've got this in place. I'm going to line this up and try and get an angle for where I need to actually attach this. So if we put this in there, we can angle it probably into that little section there. Mickey Care, thank you very much. I was like, what is that, DKK 500, is about £50? Wow, thank you very much. I always loved and enjoy kit bashing. You've given me a lot of inspiration with my own hobby, along with craving new projects. Can't support with membership, but I can do one-time donation. Thank you for the great work. Thank you very much. I really do appreciate that. That's it is kind of why I do all this. I do really enjoy it when people say that they never have done kit bashing before, or they've wanted to do. They wanted to try it out but never really had the confidence to, and just seeing someone else do it first is just a bit, gives them a bit more of a push to do it themselves. And that's all I kind of want to hear really from people. Just, yeah, I did some kit bashes myself because I saw your video doing them, or tried this out myself. Even if people like do it better than me, do like a better job of it, I don't mind, because I just want the idea of some people giving it a go, because I enjoy it really. I have done ever since I first started doing conversions, so I just want to spread the love, make sure everyone gets to enjoy converting, gets to enjoy the experience, how fun it is having a really extensive bits box, being able to jump in there. Okay, so I think this wire should be long enough. I'll push it in a little bit further just in case. Deathcore G crit donation 500. Yeah. I'm surprised actually, considering I chopped up some of their comrades to make some Valhallans. I'm surprised they want anything to do with me. Let's drill that hole a little bit further actually, just in case it's not quite deep enough for this rod to go in. Red Lotus 101, I'm just picturing these guys have a rocket launcher that fires missiles that explode into flames. Now that actually reminded me of, has anyone played the old Mercenaries game? Maybe not the first one, but one of the most recent ones that they did actually, which was quite a while ago actually. Look at that actually worked first time. How is it the other one took so much longer to do and this one just works straight away? Apologies about the dog barking outside if you can hear it. It's one of the neighbor's dogs. Just likes to go outside and bark at everything. Look at that. There we go. We've actually got some progress. I was worried that we wouldn't even get this far on the conversion, so I'm quite happy that we've managed to get some sort of weapon out of this as well. There we go. So the arm's a bit janky, that's fine, because we stick a shoulder pad on that and you can't see it. It's all good. Let's wait for that to dry. Let's have a quick look. So yes, Red Lotus 101. The old Mercenary games, there was a, I think it was either that one, the old Just Cause games, but there was a bomb that you could buy, which is like a massive kind of firebomb, and that just reminded me of that. That was pretty cool. He's looking fire, dude. Thank you very much. I assume that was the pun unintended. Cover up those mutations, dead. Add fire coming out of the gaps, could do. That would work because if he's like burning up, I could fill in any gaps with like just flaming fire. I've kind of got like a combination of some sort of. It's kind of like I don't actually need that bit. I think that's where the original handle was. Let's just clip that off for now because it's kind of breaking the profile. There we go, it's a bit better. Kind of a mixture of chaos and like overzealous imperial. I suppose it kind of has that fine line between them. Backpacks. What options do we have? This one's quite a nice one, with a little kind of vents coming out of it. That's quite a nice little backpack that we can use. I'm going to need some shoulder pads as well. I'm just trying to think what shoulder pads would be good for this. I mean, I've got Mark III shoulder pads just sitting right here. I could just. No, they're Mark IV. Got some Mark III backpacks, though. There we go. Mark III shoulder pads. I do love Mark III shoulder pads. Fiery ones. Pete started to use the paints I used, Tamiya and Mr. Color. Mr. Color, think you would like Mr. Color Primaries. Oh, I haven't heard of those. I'll have to give them a go. He's just a perfectly normal redemptionist. He pretty much is. That's why I need to go a little bit. I think once I've painted him and I've got this kind of fire going on his face, it'll look a bit more. It'll look a bit more chaos. Mark III backpacks. I think they would be actually because they have these like vents and stuff, and I think they. I do love Mark III backpacks. The answer is, will they? Look at this. This is a problem now, because I've gone like because the tops of the Mark III are so big, you can just about see how. That dog is really annoying. I don't know if you can hear it. I think that. Luckily, the microphone that I use is quite good at not picking out outdoor sounds, but he just barks. They let it out to go to the toilet and it just sits there barking. the amount of times I've been in the middle of doing like a voiceover and recording it, and I'm in the middle of recording it and I have to just stop and do the whole thing again just because of the dog. Don't worry, I like dogs. I've got a dog myself, but we can hear it all right. Yeah, it's a really annoying little yappy thing. Behind scenes question. As someone who uses both Twitch and YouTube regularly, which medium supports you best? I think because I'm very much still in early phase with Twitch, I've not done that many live streams. I don't do many regular live streams. Everything is still very much my... very much around about YouTube. So everything's, I get most of my content on YouTube, most of my views from YouTube. But I'm trying to build a Twitch. Let's bear with me one second. Let's see if we've got see if we can get the dog in. So I have my dog. this is Luna. Let's just reset that. There we go. You can see a bit better. Oh. Look at that. What's that? It's a great thing about face cam because she's really hard to get her to kind of in the normal picture. But yeah, she's Hello. It was your birthday last week, wasn't it? Eh? Yeah, that's my dog. She was asleep just so I think she's not very happy with me waking her up. We go down. There you go. Bye. There we are. yeah, so she's a little beagle and she is she's 3. Yeah, so she's not. She's quite small for a beagle, and everyone thinks she's a puppy still, but she's like a tiny. James Dixon, thank you very much. Just saw that you'd super chatted £5. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Oh, right. That's a great thing about having this face cam now. I can bring in the various pets into the streams. Where were we? Let's switch back to table and face. Zoom in. There we go. Perfect. Right. Since I had a chance to dry, we just need some shoulder pads now. And that should probably help to finish things off, I think. I'm still not quite decided. I think the Mark III shoulder pads aren't going to work too much. I might just stick to the regular Chaos Space Marine shoulder pads. They're not quite, yeah, the profile of them, if you look at the profile there, it's not quite as profound as, so I can fit that quite nicely against that. So I might just stick to the regular shoulder pads just to keep things nice and simple. Which one should I go for? I like these ones. They kind of have these, like, these sensors, which work well for the fire effect. I can maybe add something to them instead. That might work as well. Will you ever do a Nurgle guy to fit in the Warband to show some believe in different gods in the Warband? Use a spiky one. They're all spiky. I literally went to look and thinking, they're all spiky. They're all spiky. I could possibly borrow. Let's have a quick look at this Redemptionist sprue. There might be something I can borrow from here, which will help it to blend in a little bit. There's this little kind of thing here, which I guess is supposed to be some sort of like flaming lamp. Actually, I might have an idea. Oops. This is another box. This is where I keep my old skeleton stuffs. So, I'm thinking that there might be some options in, what are they called? They're not Graveguard, they are Hexwraiths. So the Hexwraith kit has some quite nice, like, flaming heads in there. So that particular one there work quite nicely on a skull. Just that kind of perched pop there. And that fits into like what someone else was saying about having this kind of dead animal bits in here. There we go. Let's go for that. Also, what do we think? Horns or no horns? Should I clip those off? Keep them? More spikes? Too much? Let's see. I'll leave that there for now. There is a couple of other sprues, actually. What about candles? Since this guy is inspired by a chord or two and they use candles. Yes, I could do. I did have a candle kit, actually, like from Green Stuff World. I don't know where they are, actually. Keep the horns. Yeah, okay. Let's go for that. Right, whilst I'm doing this and just sorting that out, have a think about what shoulder pads. Some people might have already said, but I do apologise if I missed them. I just want to kind of get an idea of what is going on with the... So is that actually a chainsaw he's got? Yeah, so he's basically got a chainsaw, but there's also like a little bit of a flamethrower mixed in as well. So just in case your flamethrower doesn't do the job, you can set fire to them as well. You can literally make pulled pork out of any enemies that you come across. Let's quickly clean these up. Perfect. And then the same for this one. It's an older kit, so I imagine that the mold lines will be a bit... Oh, yeah, they are a bit. Should give him one of the spiky shoulder pads. Chain flame sword, yeah. No horns, they'd snag on the neck spikes. Yeah, I think... I imagine that, like, if Chaos Space Marines ever, like, walk past, like, tapestries or anything in the monasteries, you're just, like, constantly, like, snagging them and pulling all these, like, forbidden tapestries that have got the face of Zeench and stuff on them. It's constantly getting rips in the curtains, like some sort of demented cat. So I think I just need to make a few adjustments here. There's nothing too... It actually works surprisingly well. That does as a, like a little adornment. I might just trim that back a little bit just so it sits a little bit better against the skull. Let's glue this on. Is it ready? Let's trim these little pipes down a little bit just so we've got a bit more room to work with. A little bit more trims. Oops. These pipes are really getting in the way. Rid of them completely. There we go. Done. Right, let's put a bit of glue on here and glue this into place. And hopefully I didn't glue the flames too far back. And yeah, there we go. Perfect. That. Love it when a plan comes together. So the only thing I'm like not super happy with is the fire going this way. I would prefer it to go back, but that's not too bad. If I, as long as I made all the, any of the flames on here go the same direction, it kind of looks like there's some sort of evil wind behind them. Right, shoulder pads. So there's not as much of a choice really. I think the regular Space Marines have more choice when it comes to shoulder pads. I might just go for regular Chaos Space Marine shoulders. Actually, I know what I'll go for. That said, where is that kit gone? There we go. These are some nice kind of like vents in the Warp Talon ones or the Raptor ones. So they're kind of perfect. Yeah. Let's go for these. Nice and spiky. Just Kev, hey Pete, do you kitbash whole armies or do you have fun experimenting? So it used to be a case that I only ever really did individual models and I didn't really do much in the way of large scale conversion work or anything like that. But recently I finished a 2,000 point Age of Sigmar army, where I painted up, converted and painted everything, and kind of had like a Nurgle Sylvaneth effect, which was quite nice. A lot of work, but yeah, it was nice to convert everything in like a large scale for once. So, question: do you know, just know every detail of every kit offhand or what? So yeah, I think there's obviously some kits which I don't know. I'm not as familiar with, but a lot of kits I have at some point looked at the sprues on Games Workshop or on like bit sellers just to see what they've got in there. So it kind of gives me an idea, and I usually have like a mental idea of what is contained within each kit, and I can just kind of go to that particular kit if I know I need shoulder pads. I know that when it comes to Chaos Space Marines, there's not that much choice for good shoulder pads. You've got the Chaos Space Marines, Havocs, and the Raptor Warp Talon set, there's not tons of options. Whereas like Space Marines, you've got all the Mark III stuff, you've got all the Mark IV stuff, all the stuff from Firstborn, everything from any of like the specialist kits that have come out there. You've got like things like Thousand Suns and Death Guard shoulder pads, but they're very, very specific to one particular theme, so they're harder to just use more generically across the entire army. But yeah, it's just mainly experience. When you spend so much time looking at various kits for just little details, then you often pick up stuff and you can kind of retrieve that information whenever you need it. There you go, sufficiently evil enough. And then we go for this one as well. Cover up some of those the lens that we made. There we go. I think that is fairly close to being done, because I didn't want to go too heavy on this conversion. I wanted it to look more like a rank and file member, as opposed to being something really elite and specialized. So it was nice to just do something a bit more straightforward. I'll possibly paint this up in another stream. It depends, really. Everyone seems to prefer the conversion live streams, but I mean, maybe it's like nice to do a combination of a conversion and then a painting guide later on. So yeah, that's this guy here. What time is it now? Yeah, it's 9:30 now. So I think I'm going to call that an evening, and I'm going to go and veg out and watch TV for a bit after this. After I've tidied up all the multitude of sprues and kits that I've left around me. So yeah, thank you everyone who has joined me. I'm happy to answer a few more questions. So if you want to get those last few questions in, then please do let me know, and I will quickly rapid fire them off now. So how are you going to base him? I will probably use copious amounts of skulls that I can kind of char and make a lot burnt and everything. Rebel Jesus, what pets do you have? I have a rabbit who is very old. She's like 12 years old now. I have a chinchilla, I have two cats, and I have a dog. So that's all of those. Zibber tipped £4.28. Thank you very much, Zibber. I do appreciate the help, that last minute tip in there. I think you've got the last one in there, so thank you very much. Tau Kill Team next. Possibly there's that new Tau Kill Team that's been hinted that's going to come out, so maybe I'll wait till that kit comes out and do some nice cool stuff with that, maybe trying to convert it to something a little bit different. In somewhat like the converting Templar's army, any advice for making purity seals? Do you prefer green stuff or thin metal pieces? I've heard people use both. What would you recommend? I've never used the thin metal pieces, so I can't... I can't comment on them myself. But... I like to use plastic in my conversion, so I'd probably use plastic card, like a thin plastic card, and then just like shave down the edges and make some kind of strips out of that. Or I would just do the whole thing in green stuff. I've used those kind of things a few times, but I like green stuff because you can bend it more like cloth. You can add folds and cuts into it. You can make it look more like the plastic purity seals that you find. So yeah, that's probably what I would go for there, personally. Right, have we got any more? Do you ever not kit bash? I mean, technically that 3D printed army wasn't kit bashed. I just used the kits as they were intended to be. So sometimes I do, yeah. Did you ask Mrs. the Wargamer to try painting for it? Yes, yeah, so I think she would maybe want to be happy to do something like paint the same model. I would paint it and she would paint it as well. I don't think she'd maybe want to be on the video. I think she's as bothered about being on a camera as I am. But yeah, maybe. Zibia, thanks for the cool content. You're very much welcome. Thank you for the tip. Leechik, HH conversions ever? Possibly. There was that Horus Heresy box set that was leaked a while ago. And if that ever sees the light of day, then probably we'll do some more Horus Heresy stuff. I did do some originally when the Mark 3 and Mark 4 kits came out, so I'll maybe do a few more later on. Have a good night, Pete, when it comes to that. Thanks for the stream. Thank you very much for joining. I do appreciate everyone else who decided to join this. Where would we be able to see the painted model for this guy? It depends, really. If I end up doing it on a stream, then it will be see on the stream. If not, I'm not sure when I will paint him, so we can see. But yeah. Cool. I think that is probably what I'm going to call the stream the end. I can thank you for kind of bearing with me with the initial technical issues where I just hadn't unmuted the mic or set up my mic properly. So, but look, I can do some nice cool stuff now. I can zoom in. It's just on my mouth and my eyes. Look at that. Lovely. I can play around with these buttons all day. But yeah, so I think that was what we were going for. We got fairly similar. The only thing I didn't do with this particular one was add the shield, but I don't think it needed it in the end. The direction that I went with the model wasn't too bad. So yeah, quite happy with the results. Thank you everyone for joining me, and as always, make sure you are subscribed if you don't. I reckon you probably already subscribed if you're here. If you're not subscribed, then please do subscribe. Usually conversions every week if I get the time. Some weeks I have a break. And yeah, thanks everyone who supports me on Patreon. I've just added some like merch options on there, so you can get some like mugs and stickers and hoodies, and depending on what tiers you back me on Patreon for. If you use affiliates links, thank you very much. If you use super chats and the tips, thank you very much, because it means I can pay for all this stuff and actually have plenty of options to do these conversions for you. So thank you very much. And until next time, goodbye.